Hello everyone, in this video we are going to deal with the draft analysis used in the mold tools. So before going there, first let me introduce the concept of the draft analysis. So you might study that in the design of the pattern or mold we are using some draft angles instead of vertical faces, because if we are using the vertical faces on the pattern, so while removing the pattern from the mold, there may be the negative pressure generated and it may cause the damage to the molding surface, and subsequently it will damage the casting. So now also, if we are using the vertical surfaces, then while removing that surface or pattern, due to the adhering property of the molding sand, it will damage the surface. So now what we are doing, that we are providing some taper angle, so that while removing that, we can reduce the chances of sticking the surface of the pattern with the molding sand, and we can reduce the damage to the molding surface. So here SOLIDWORKS also provides us a tool known as the draft analysis, which enables us to determine which are the faces that require the draft to be provided while designing the pattern. So now let's start it. For that, first we have to add here the mold tools. For that, first we'll just right click once, and here we'll check it, mold tools. So you can here see that the mold tools is available, and now here one option, draft analysis, you can see here. So first we'll check it once. So this type of window you can see on your screen. Now after the draft analysis, so what we have to do is that we have to first determine that from which plane we are going to separate the two mold boxes, and this is the box where we have to give the plane from which we are going to separate two molds. So here in our case we will give here the top plane. So when I check here the top plane, this gives me some color coding. So let's see what are those color codings. So first here in below here you can see that draft angle. So depending upon the design of the pattern, and depending upon the material to be casted, and depending on the material of the pattern, we are using different draft angles for different types of pattern. So here this depends upon the pattern material. Now here you can see three colors are available: green, yellow and red. So here the green color indicates that these are the faces which are having the positive drafts, and here this red color indicates that these are the surfaces that are having the negative draft, and here this yellow faces, and which indicates that these two yellow faces requires the draft, because while removal it having the vertical surfaces and they may cause damage to the mold surface. So here we have these two surfaces which requires the draft. Now here there are the different options available. So here the first option is adjustment triad. So here when we check it, then on our the separation plane, this will show one ring, and here these two half rings. So it gives us the possibilities of different planes while we select, such that it will give us the corresponding color coding to different surfaces. So when I just gives like this, so according to now my plan is this. So according to my plan, it is giving the different color coding of the different faces. So generally this option adjustment triad is used when your pattern is having more number of faces and you are trying to get the optimum plane from which you want to separate the two mold boxes. So this is used to find out the best plane of separating the mold. So adjustment triad is a try and error method, and that is used to determine the which plane we have to use to separate the two mold boxes. So in our case, I have selected this plane. So I will select the top plane. Now the second option is the face classification. So this option is only used when you have more than, when you have number of faces and you want that which faces are having the positive draft, which are having the negative draft, and which surfaces are having the, which surfaces are we have to give the draft. So here you can see that here show and hide buttons are available in all the different faces color code, and here in last you can see that the straddle faces. So these are the faces which are having both the positive as well as the negative draft. So here in our case there is no such face. I will show you one different example in which we will see the straddle faces. So now if we have a pattern in which there are n number of faces and all the faces are having the different drafts, and if you want to distinguish all the faces according to the draft angle, then here you can see this show and hide button. So if I want to see that which are the faces that requires the draft, then I can simply hide this and this green and red color faces. So I came to know that there are only two faces which requires the draft, and likewise you can make show and hide all the faces according to their requirement. So now let us move to the another example. So let us take this another example, and here also we will analyze the drafts. So go to the draft analysis, and we'll also select here the top plane. So now here while selecting top plane, you can also see that there are three colors, and here in this box you can see that there are 15 faces which are having the positive draft. So here there is 403, and here 58, and here 4. So in the previous example we have no straddle faces, but here right now we have 4 straddle faces. So I have told you that the straddle faces are those faces which are having both the positive as well as negative draft angles, and there might be also the zero draft angle also. So here you can see that this is the straddle face. So let us first we will hide these all, and you can see that there are only 4 faces. This is the first face, this is the second, and this is the third, and this is the fourth. So there are only 4 faces which are the straddle faces. It means they are having both the positive and negative draft angles. So likewise you can see the different faces according to the draft angle. Now there is another option that you can check on and off, that is the find stiff faces. So when you just click on this, then you have the two another options that are the positive stiff faces and negative stiff faces. So according to the angle of these faces with the parting plane, you can also have these positive stiff faces and negative stiff faces, and also you can simply make hide and show of those faces. So now let us uncheck this, and one thing that you should know, find the stiff faces check button only available when you have checked the face classification. So when you just check it off, this third option will automatically goes off. And now there is last option, that is the gradual transition. So when I simply click over the gradual transition, then here in our model it is not available with the naked eye that we can see the gradual transition of the different faces. But here you can see that gradual transition starts from the draft angle that we have given here, and from that it will goes to 0 and it will goes to minus of that value. So it simply states that here when you have number of faces in your pattern, then there is some faces that require the 3 degree of draft angle. There are some which are having the 1.5, there are some faces which are having 0 degree of draft angle, and some requires the negative. So according to their faces, it will give you the different color codes according to your draft angle. So by this you can just make the similarity that which color is having which of draft angle. So it's used when you have the surfaces like gradual surfaces in which your draft angle continuously change, and in those case you can use the gradual transition to see at which location your surface is having the which draft angle. So this is all about the draft analysis. So draft analysis is used to give you the draft in your pattern. So here first let us move to this example, and here you can have the two faces which requires the draft, which are in yellow color. So you simply can give the draft by using this draft button, or you can give the draft from your feature also. So here we simply first click on the draft, and here we have to select the neutral plane. So here we will give the top plane as a neutral plane, and here simply we have to select the faces which requires the draft, so that are indicated by the yellow color. So we will select this, and here we will select this face. So we have selected these two faces, and here the draft angle given is of 1 degree, and simply we will click on the apply. So you can see that here it has given the draft to our pattern according to the neutral plane. So here you can see this, the draft that is given by this. So this is what about the draft analysis and draft angle.